Hello, you're watching Hornbill TV's Northeast Express Bulletin. The president of the Assam Trinamool Congress, Ribbon Bora, has resigned from the party. His letter to the party's National General Secretary, Abhishek Banerjee, read that the Assam TMC has great potential, but several recurring issues have hindered its progress, including the perception of TMC as a regional party of West Bengal. To counter this perception, the unit had made several suggestions, such as the need for an Assamese leader at the national level, declaring the residence of Bharat Ratna Dr. Bhupen Hazarika at Toligunj as a heritage site and converting the Matubur Satra at Guj Bihar into a cultural hub. Despite his repeated attempts over the past year and a half to secure an appointment with Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee to address these concerns, he has been unsuccessful. YouTuber Aldaf Hussein has finally been arrested by Gauripur police after performing songs allegedly against the Assamese and uploading them on his page. Aldaf Hussein, 28 years, a resident of Assam's Thubri, was arrested on charges of inciting communal sentiments by performing a controversial song to create conflict between the Assamese and the Mia or Muslim people. Despite attracting criticism from various ethnic groups, the song has thousands of views on the social media. The incident comes amid heightened tension between Mias and the indigenous communities of Assam following the recent rape of a minor girl by three youths from a minority community in Nagaon district. Aldaf Hussein is in police custody. A team of Manipur police have arrested an active cadre of the United People's Party of Kangle Bak, a faction of the People's Revolutionary Party of Kangle Bak. The cadre was arrested from Tamna Bokpi in Bishnupur district on Saturday on charge of extortion. The arrested person was identified as one Name Rakpam Ningto Mede, 42 years. He was involved in monetary demands and extortion, from the public updates stated. The police team seized three mobile handsets worth 10,000 in cash and a four-wheel vehicle from his possession. In a similar incident on Saturday, the Manipur police team arrested one individual who was allegedly extorting money from vehicles from Old Kacha Road in Bishnupur district. He was identified as one Chabungbam Bishwarjit Singh, 28 years. He was extorting money in the name of a group claimed to be ULF. A receipt book marked ULF entry tax was recovered from his possession. The arrested person and the seized items have been handed over to the police for further legal action, police report said. A socio-cultural organization, Biadigram Mastu, and the Information and Cultural Affairs Department of the Government of Tripura and News Bengal 365 is all set to celebrate the 98th birth anniversary of Bharat Ratna Dr. Bhupen Hazarika on September 7 in the town hall of Akartala in Tripura. To announce it, a press meet was organized on August 31 at Guwahati Press Club, Ambari. Distinguished guests attending Tripura include Tripura Governor Indra Sena Bedi Nalu, Chief Minister Manik Saha, Chief Whip of Tripura Government Kalyani Saha Roy, Deputy Speaker Ram Prasad Bol, and renowned writer Dr. Rita Chaudhary. Biadigram Mastu has been organizing cultural programs in India and abroad for more than a decade to commemorate Dr. Hazarika's birth anniversary, promoting his legacy nationally and internationally. This year, the 98th birth anniversary celebration will be attended by a total of 30 delegates, including Bhupen Hazarika's family members and relatives. The Bharat Ratna Bhupen Hazarika Biadigram International Award 2024 will be conferred upon D.T. Debarman, a celebrated musician from Tripura. Dr. Sauman Bhari said Dr. Bhupen Hazarika, known as Sutha Kanda, was not just a musician but an institution. He used music as a tool for social revolution, Bhardia said. The establishment aims to sustain Hazarika's legacy through the events, Bhardia said.
We have collaborated with them so that we can celebrate Dr. Bhupen Hazarika there. And in upcoming time, we are also trying to celebrate S.D. Burman sir here in Guwahati. We are very glad for that. We have got the opportunity to do so. And we are trying our best so that we can, you know, make a successful show out of it. From here, we are quite a few participants who are performing there. And even participants from Agartala is also participating in this program. They are also performing. So we are very glad that we got this opportunity to do so, and we are trying our level best so that we can genuinely make a very good program and we can celebrate Dr. Bhupen Hazarika as much as possible from our end. This is his 98th birth anniversary, and we hope we can do justice to the program.
Vatikram Mazdur Uddugat Tripura Bhupen Hazarika 98 সংখ্যক জন্ম শতবার্ষিকী জন্মবার্ষিকী উদযাপন করব। গতি এই বড় আদরণীয় কথা। আমার লগতে যে মরম চেনেহ তেখেতে আদান প্রদান মানুষের যখন আমার সেইখানে আমার আকো পুনের গড় উঠিব, মানে আমার মজবুত হব। ভূপেন্দ্রা সদায় মানুষের মাজর মানুষ আছে, মই এখার কথা কইছো। ভূপেন্দ্রায় গান লিখিছিলে, অজস্র গান লিখেছে ভূপেন্দ্রায়, প্রতিটি গানেই ভূপেন্দ্রায় নিজে গাই থাকে, নিজে কণ্ঠত রেকর্ড করে থাকে গেছে। গতি ভূপেন্দ্রাক আমি আর কর্মশালা পাতি ভূপেন্দ্রার গান শিকাবলিয়া নহয়, ভূপেন্দ্রায় নিজে শিকাব পারে। এটিও ভূপেন্দ্রা নাই যদিও ভূপেন্দ্রার কণ্ঠটা শুনিলেই 100 বার শুনিলে একটা ভুল শুদ্ধ হব, বেলেগে নাথাকে। ভূপেন্দ্রার বিখ্যাত গান এটা আপনাদের সকলে জানে যে মানুষে মানুষের বাদে।
নিউজ বেঙ্গল 365-র সহযোগত ত্রিপুরাত আমি 7 সেপ্টেম্বর ভূপেন হাজরিকার 98তম জন্মবার্ষিকী পালন করে আছো। তাতে আমার 30 জনের একটা দল হয়ে আছে, যাতে সমর হাজরিকা, টাওয়ার হাজরিকা, ডক্টর মৌসুমী শহরিয়ার, সংস্কৃত কলাকার ধরি শিল্পীখিনি আমার হয়ে আছে। লগতে ত্রিপুরাত পড়ি থাকা আমার অসমীয়া শিল্পী যেগুলো ত্রিপুরা ইউনিভার্সিটিত পড়ি আছে, বহুতখিনি আমার অসমীয়া লড়া ছোৱালী আছে, তেওঁলোকেও তাতে গান গাইছত অংকন করব। আর প্রতি বছর আমি ভূপেন হাজরিকার নামত একটা অ্যাওয়ার্ড দিই, ডক্টর ভূপেন হাজরিকা ব্যতিক্রম আন্তর্জাতিক অ্যাওয়ার্ড। এবার আমি এই ত্রিপুরার প্রখ্যাত শিল্পী তিথি দেববর্মনক এই অ্যাওয়ার্ডটা আমি দিয়ে আছো। আর ত্রিপুরার সন্তান এসডি বর্মন, শচীন দেববর্মন, তেখেতর প্রয়াণ দিবস 31 অক্টোবরটো আমি গুৱাহাটীত শংকৰদেৱ কলাক্ষেত্ৰত পাতি আছো।
Tripura Chief Minister Manik Saha on Sunday expressed his gratitude to Assam Chief Minister Hemanta Biswa Sarma for donating INR 5 crore to assist the flood victims in Tripura. The donation was presented by Assam's Minister of Tourism Jayanta Mala Barua to the Chief Minister at his official residence in Agartala. Manik Saha stated in a post on X that he was deeply grateful to the people of Assam and Chief Minister Hemanta Biswa Sarma for extending a helping hand to Tripura in its time of need. A check of INR 5 crore was handed over by Minister Jayanta Mala today, symbolizing the solidarity and support from the people of Assam, Saha said. He expressed gratitude for the kindness, generosity and compassion. The contribution will go a long way in helping Tripura overcome the challenges posed by the floods, Saha said. Financial contributions for flood relief were being deposited daily into the Chief Minister's relief fund from various sources, an official statement said on Saturday. The chief ministers of several states, including Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Arunachal Pradesh, have extended their support to Tripura. The central government has also announced a financial package, with Prime Minister Narendra Modi pledging financial assistance for the flood victims, a statement had said. In recent days, individuals from various professions have been making contributions to the chief minister's relief fund, and this trend continued Saturday as well. In a post on X, CM Saha thanked the various organizations for their generous donations. Following continuous rainfall and unprecedented floods since August 19 in the state, 31 people have lost their lives and over 72,000 people have been displaced so far. According to a press release by the State Relief Rehabilitation and Disaster Management Department, as per a government statement, a total of 492 relief camps had been set up by the district administration, providing shelter to the people displaced by the floods. Clothing has also been distributed to about 300 needy people in the Amarpur and Karbuk subdivisions. By fulfilling its promise of providing 1 lakh government jobs, the Assam government will distribute appointment letters to more than 23,900 teachers on September 2. The ceremonial distribution of permanent teacher appointment letters to 23,956 contractual teachers under Samagra Shiksha will be held at Kanabara Veterinary College Field in Guwahati. which is the total recruitment of government jobs in the state in the past 3 years will increase up to 1,24,345. Assam Education Minister Ranoj Begu posted on X stating that the promise had been fulfilled. The teachers will be posted in the schools where they were previously serving as SSA, state contractual teachers, he stated. Candidates in the withheld list are advised to contact the Director of Elementary Education with their documents, he stated. Following the High Court's order on August 30, 2024, the minister stated, which lifted the stay on the advertisement dated August 5, 2024, for the special recruitment drive for experienced SSA and state pool contractual teachers, the Assam government is proceeding with the selection process. A total of 27,790 candidates have applied, and the Education Department has completed the verification and selection process, he said. During the 2021 assembly polls in the state, Chief Minister Hemanta Biswa Sarma had promised to give 1 lakh government jobs in the state. According to the government data, till August 26 this year, appointment letters were distributed to 1,389,000 candidates, including Government of Assam employees employed in Bodoland Territorial Council and Karbi Anglong Autonomous Council. Union Minister Pralhad Joshi has said that the state assemblies or the parliament are not places to offer prayers. He was responding to former Bihar Deputy Chief Minister Tejaswi Yadav attacking the Assam government for banning namaz breaks in the Assam Legislative Assembly. On RJD leader Tejaswi Yadav's remarks at Assam Chief Minister Hemanta Biswa Sarma for the Assam Assembly scrubbing Friday namaz breaks, Pralhad Joshi asked if the Assembly, Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha places for offering namaz. The Union Minister called it the height of abasement politics. He asked if a country is run like this.
नमाज करना कहा बंद कर दिया है? असेंबली नमाज करने के लिए है क्या? राज्यसभा लोकसभा नमाज करने के लिए है क्या? ये तो अपीजमेंट का पॉलिटिक्स का पराकाष्ठा है. दिस इज द हाइट ऑफ द अपीजमेंट पॉलिटिक्स. एंड कई जगह फ्राइडे को दोपहर मैं तो ऐसे तो मैं अगर मेरा इंडिविजुअल बोलता हूं, मैं पार्लियामेंट अफेयर्स मंत्री था, मैं किसी देव देवता को आराधन करता हूं तो आई एम डिसाइपल ऑफ श्री राघवेंद्र स्वामी, गुरुवार को मुझे रेस्ट दे दो, ऐसे चलता है क्या देश? दुनिया में जो है वो उसके आधार पर चलता है जी. तो हम फ्राइडे को बंद करेंगे, क्या तरीका है? क्यों रखना चाहिए इसको? तो सबको संडे बंद, संडे बंद सबको रहना चाहिए. मैं बोलता हूं ये लोग कोई आके बोलेंगे हमको संडे नहीं चाहिए, हमको मंडे छुट्टी चाहिए, हम शिव का भक्त है, ये चलता है क्या? ये बेवकूफी है.
Rashtriya Janata Dal leader Tejaswi Yadav hit out at the Assam Chief Minister Hemanta Biswa Sarma of the decision to end the 2-hour break for Juma prayers in Assam Assembly and accused him of seeking cheap popularity to stay in the news. Assam Chief Minister wants cheap popularity and wants to remain in the news. Yogi Adityanath is using bulldozers and he is stopping namaz. The country belongs to everyone. There should be peace. But these people are only spreading hatred, Tejaswi Yadav told ANI.
जो आसाम के जो मुख्यमंत्री हैं, वो सस्ती लोकप्रियता के लिए इस तरह से करते हैं. ये हैं कौन? ये केवल सस्ती लोकप्रियता चाहते हैं. और ये भाजपा के लोग गोने मुसलमान भाइयों को एक सॉफ्ट टारगेट बना लिया. कभी वक्फ बोर्ड का आ जाता है बिल, कभी CA NRC का आ जाता है बिल. किसी ना किसी प्रकार से ये माइनॉरिटी के लोगों को, अल्पसंख्यक को, ये भाजपा के लोग तंग करना चाहते हैं, समाज में नफरत घृणा पैदा कराना चाहते हैं. ये लोगों को पता होना चाहिए कि देश के आज़ादी में सभी लोगों का कुर्बानी रहा है, मुसलमान भाइयों का भी रहा है. इसको दरकिनार नहीं किया जा सकता. और इस देश में संविधान के अनुसार सभी को जो है इजाज़त है, हर धर्म को समानता है, हर धर्म का मान्यता है, ये हमारे संविधान में है. लेकिन ये भाजपा के लोग, आपको पता है ये विधानसभा में वो भाजपा का MLA या मंत्री बंदर की तरह कूद रहा था. अब बोल रहा था कि वोटिंग का अधिकार छीन लेंगे मुसलमानों का. हम एक बार खड़ा हुए, ठंडा दिए उसको, उसके बाद से खड़ा हुआ है क्या कोई? ये भाजपा के लोग इसी तरीके का काम करते रहते हैं. और आश्चर्य की बात है, मुख्यमंत्री क्यों चुप है इस मामले में? कोई माइक लाल नहीं है हम लोगों के रहते हुए मुसलमान भाइयों का अधिकार छीन सके. हम लोग हमेशा से लड़ते रहे और आगे भी लड़ते रहे। अरे देखिए, हम बार बार कहते हैं जो वहाँ के मुख्यमंत्री हैं वो सस्ती लोकप्रियता चाहते हैं और इस तरह का खुश मतलब खबरों में रहकर में बना रहना चाहते हैं। और हमने कल भी ट्वीट किया था, ये योगी जी के चाइनीज रेप्लिका है। ये चाहते हैं कि भाई पूरी तरीके से जो है माहौल जो है बिगड़े। वहां योगी जी बुलडोजर चलवा रहे हैं, यहाँ नवाज जो है बंद करवाने का काम कर रहे हैं। तो देखिए, देश जो है सबों का देश है, अमन चैन शांति होनी चाहिए, लेकिन ये लोग केवल नफरत फैला रहे हैं। यहाँ बिहार में भी एक एमएलए या मंत्री कूद कूद करके बोल रहे थे कि मुसलमानों का हम जो है वोटिंग का अधिकार छीन लेंगे। हम उसको ठंडा किए, तब से बोला नहीं है कोई। अब ये हम लोगों के रहते हुए कोई भी उनके अधिकार या सम्मान की बात आएगी तो हम लोग लड़ाई लड़ेंगे।
That's all for now. Keep watching Hornbill TV.